In this video, we're gonna talk about the best MacBook to buy for programmers and developers. MacBooks are a great option for most developers. Not all of them, there are exceptions, and we'll talk about those down the line. But for most developers, they're gonna be great. The thing is, depending on your workload and your budget, you might be fine with like a refurbished M2 Air, or you might need a maxed out MacBook Pro with all of the best specs. So this video is here to help. We're gonna answer all of your questions and then give you a couple key buying recommendations at every single price point. I'm gonna try to break it down in simple terms, so if you don't know that much about different computer terms, don't worry, you will be perfectly fine. If you're new here, my name's Ben, and I work at a startup where part of what we do is help people find the right MacBook for their needs, whether they're a developer or a designer or a business owner or anything else. I talk to a lot of developers, both on our team and online. I also spend way too much time reading Reddit threads about this and watching YouTube videos to stay up to date on what people really need. So this video is here to help cover all of the questions you have and give you simple buying recommendations. Whether you're just getting started with programming or building multi-platform apps, front end, back end, or doing like AI and ML work, we will cover everything and I'll give you recommendations based on budget and what sort of work you're doing. But we're gonna do more than that because I want to give as much key info as possible for your development experience. So we will cover some of the best tools for Mac developers, key accessories you should have, and where to find deals and save money. With that, let's jump in. First, in order to figure out what MacBook is right for you, we have to figure out what kind of programmer you are, what sort of work you're doing. Now, if you are writing mostly HTML, CSS, JavaScript, working in VS Code, or building simple sites, you are in the lightweight category. Now, if you're building mobile apps with things like Xcode or Android Studio or Flutter, your needs are gonna go up a notch, especially in terms of RAM and CPU. Now, if you are doing machine learning or data science or training models locally, your needs are gonna go up another notch. So this is where you're gonna wanna start caring more about GPU, more RAM will always be good, and probably more storage. This is gonna put you kind of in the middleweight category. Then, if you are doing full stack or backend development, you got handling local databases, if you're doing larger projects using Docker, this is where you're gonna go up again to another level. We'll call this the heavyweight category. This is where you are really gonna need solid multitasking and thermal headroom. And then lastly, if you're doing like game development, Unity or Unreal, compiling shaders, that's where you're gonna really need a higher end chip with great GPU. Same also goes for the heavier types of AI work. So this is the ultra heavyweight category. Now, before we jump into picks, let's talk about what specs matter the most for developers. The biggest one is going to be RAM. RAM lets you handle multiple processes at once. So if you're running multiple apps, projects, Docker, that's where this really starts to be important. 16 gigabytes is what I would recommend as the minimum for most developers. But if you're going up to higher levels, 24 or even 36 gigabytes would be recommended. At the highest levels, you can get like 128 gigs of RAM. That is not necessary for most people, but at the higher levels, it can be good. Next up is CPU performance, especially single core speed, because this is key for tasks like compiling code. And this is why the newer chips like the M4 are often worth the investment, because they're going to have much faster processors. Then there's GPU, which is your graphics processing unit. This isn't critical for most developers, but if you're doing any sort of stuff like game design or some sorts of AI work, then GPU starts to matter a lot. If you're unsure about whether or not GPU is important for you, I would just Google, like, here's the type of work I'm doing. Is GPU important? You'll get a bunch of clear answers. Can't answer everything in this video, but with a little bit of research, you can figure it out yourself. Then there's storage. Here, 512 gigabytes is good for most people. If you're working with really large projects and databases and you have a ton of local files, it might make sense to bump it up to 1 terabyte. Nowadays though, so many things are able to be stored in the cloud or run online, so it matters a little bit less, but you really do not want to be running out of storage during a critical project. And then lastly is thermals and cooling. So the MacBook Pro has a fan, the MacBook Air does not, which means that it's silent, which is cool, but under the heavier loads, when you're, it's like really intensive compiling, that can start to slow down and throttle your speed. So just keep that in mind. If you're doing more intensive work, you probably want to get the MacBook Pro where you will have that cooling system. Okay, and now time for the actual picks, my recommendations. We're gonna break it down by budget. So I will give you a budget option, middle of the road option, and then a no holds barred performance option. So the budget pick, this is really good for people who are students, beginners, or mostly like web developers using kind of the lightweight tools. For that sort of work, you don't necessarily need the latest machine. So here I would recommend a refurbished M2 or M3 MacBook Air with 16 gigabytes of RAM. You can usually find these in kind of like the $700 to $1,000 range, especially if you look at refurbishment sites like Apple's refurbishment program or sites like Backmarket. These laptops are fanless, they're light, and they have amazing battery life. These laptops will handle code editors like VS Code very easily. Same with local servers, even like Node.js. You'll be good on all of those fronts. One thing to call out there, I would recommend upgrading the RAM to 16 gigabytes, as I said, just that the base models here will start at 8 gigabytes, so keep that in mind. And then the other thing to note is that the M2 and M3 Airs only support one external display. So if you're the type of guy who has like all of these different monitors, you're not gonna be able to do that with these laptops. Another really good option here is the refurbished MacBook Pro M1 from 2020. This is actually my previous laptop, and I would run VS Code, Cursor on there, and used to do some big like data analysis projects, and it worked pretty much just fine. There's like a little bit of slowdown under certain things, but for the most part, it was really great. All right, then we're gonna jump to the middle of the road option. I'm gonna cheat here and give you two. The overall best pick that I would recommend is the M4 MacBook Air, but with 512 gigabytes of storage and either 16 gigabytes of RAM, which is the base model, what that comes with, or upgrade it to 24 gigabytes of RAM. The M4 chip is really solid. There's a big jump in single core performance, which is great for things like compiling Swift or running local servers. And it's fanless like all of the previous MacBook Airs, but it has really solid performance. It'll be great for people using like Xcode or Android emulators. But if you are a full stack dev and you are constantly running all of these different things, you've got your IDE, you've got some AI tool, you've got 20 browser tabs open, you've got Slack open, you've got Linear open, whatever, then I would recommend upgrading to the MacBook Pro. And here you should be fine with just the base model. It'll start at 512 gigabytes of storage and 16 gigabytes of RAM. It is more expensive. It's gonna start at $1,599 for those specs, but it will deliver great performance. And now if you are looking for performance at all costs, if you are doing things like machine learning, building huge apps, you're running local simulations or working in 3D game engines, this is where you are going to wanna spend more money and get the MacBook Pro M4 with the M4 Max chip. That is the most powerful chip that Apple has and is gonna be an absolute beast for all of the stuff that you're doing. The RAM starts at 32 gigabytes and goes all the way up to 128 gigabytes, which is insane, but can be worth it if you are operating at the highest level. The M4 Max is gonna give you significantly more GPU cores, higher memory bandwidth, and better sustained performance under load. It's ideal for long compile times, massive code bases, and GPU intensive machine learning. Also, to bring it back to something we talked about before, it supports multiple external displays. So again, if you're that guy with three big monitors to handle all your code, this is gonna be able to handle all of that. Again, it's got the active cooling, so it's not gonna get too hot. It's gonna be able to be fine under intense workloads. And now, because I know a lot of people don't only use their computer for their specific work, they're doing other creative projects on the side. So if you are like video editing or working in Blender or doing any sort of other intensive design work, the M4 Max is gonna be able to handle all of that, no problem. Now it's gonna cost you some money, but you're gonna have a lot of fun along the way because it's gonna have incredible performance and you're not gonna be stuck having all these headaches waiting for things to load that shouldn't take this long. So now if you've got your Mac and you're wondering what should I install on there first, here are the top recommendations both from online and talking to our dev team here. VS Code is still incredible as an IDE, especially now it's got all sorts of integrations with these different AI coding tools, so that's a really solid start. iTerm 2 and OhMyZeesh are a powerful terminal setup that's gonna enhance your productivity with shortcuts, themes, plugins, really solid. Then I would recommend something like Flycut, which is a clipboard manager that lets you cycle through up to 40 different copy and paste items so that as you're copying and pasting lines of code, you don't have to like constantly go back and forth. Then Homebrew, it's the go-to macOS package installer for installing almost everything, to Node, to Python, Postgres, like all of that stuff, you're gonna want it. And then I'll throw in Raycast, which is basically an alternative to Spotlight, like where you look things up on Mac. It just works better with your scripts, your extensions, and search. It kind of does it all in one. But there is a bunch more good ones, so I'll throw up a screenshot on screen of the rest. Then let's talk the best accessories for developers. There's a few here that could make a really big difference. Obviously, these are all up to you, but this is what I'd recommend. First up is some sort of ergonomic keyboard. If you're gonna be working long hours and typing all the time, eventually you will start to have issues just using the laptop, like keeping your hands here, typing like that. Next up is a mouse. Mouses keep things smoother. You don't have to use the trackpad all the time. And again, there are some ergonomic ones. If you're dealing with things like carpal tunnel syndrome, they can just make it a lot easier. And especially if you're going to be developing for many, many years, you should start to think about this stuff. Some sort of external monitor is really good. People have different opinions about this, so it's up to you, but it allows you much more screen real estate than you're gonna get with just your MacBook. An external SSD, if you have very large files and need the extra space, just keeps things freed up on your computer, so it runs a little faster. And then if you go out and about and work a lot, some sort of laptop stand would be really good so that you can avoid the tech neck where you're always like staring down at your computer like this. So those are accessories I'd recommend. Now I wanna jump into deals or how to save money when buying a MacBook, because they are certainly expensive. And luckily there's a few options. One that we've already talked about is buying used or refurbished. Unfortunately, those are gonna be harder to find for the M4 series, especially the M4 Air, which just came out a few months ago. M4 Pro, you'll be able to find some of those now. But if you're buying an older model like the M2 or M3, check sites like Backmarket or other refurbishment sites in order to get deals on ones that are used, but hopefully not used too much. If you are a student, right now we've got a lot of people going to college soon, and they're wondering, oh, what MacBook should I get? I'm thinking of doing comp sci as my degree. You can take advantage of Apple's education discount. They will give you like $100 or $150 off of your MacBook if you can prove that you're a student. And if you want to pay over time instead of dumping like $2,500 all at once for your laptop, I would recommend Upgraded. It allows you to pay over 36 months and from 0% APR. So prices start at as low as $33 a month for the M4 MacBook Air. Now this is our company, we built it, but we built it in order to make buying a MacBook as easy and affordable as possible. And I asked my boss if we could do a giveaway for viewers of this YouTube video. He said yes. So if you use the code programmer40, you can get 40 bucks off of your laptop purchase. And then we've been mentioning game development a little bit here, but I wanna bring that up as a separate topic because that's one of the areas where oftentimes it actually doesn't make sense to get a MacBook for development. A lot of game development software either isn't optimized for Mac or just doesn't even run on it. So this is one where, depending on the type of work that you're going to be doing, I'll just Google like, can I use a MacBook for this, this, and this, and see if there are options. If not, you should probably get a Windows. Other than that though, MacBooks are a great option for most programmers. Now let's wrap it all up. Recommendations. If you're a budget and kind of more towards the beginner side of the programming spectrum, I would recommend a refurbished M2 or M3 Air, but with 16 gigabytes of RAM and at least 512 gigabytes of storage. Moving up to the middle of the road option, the M4 series are gonna be great, either the M4 Air with 512 gigabytes of storage or the MacBook Pro, which just get the base model that has all the specs that you'll need. And then if you are looking purely at performance, budget really isn't an issue, or you're just gonna be making a lot of money with your laptop, so it's worth it, I would recommend the MacBook Pro with the M4 Max chip. If you are still unsure about which MacBook to buy, drop a comment below. I try to respond to all of those and I can help you out to give a little bit more tailored advice to your specific situation. Other than that, that's it. I'll see you next time.